What did you make of the statements being made up on Capitol Hill with other leaders of Anthropic, for example, and where did it land for those that are trying to regulate it? What was your message today?
Yeah, the meeting just ended 20 minutes ago. I'm actually speaking from you to you from the Senate Russell Halls, where we're just debating this vigorously for 2 hours. I feel like there's a wide range of opinions, and I think that hypes about AI doomsday scenario are overblown. When I look at the common arguments for why AI could lead us to doom, it comes down to maybe three things. One is it could happen. We're not sure how, but it could happen. And you can't disprove a negative. You can't prove a negative. Second is appeal to authority. Some other people think it could happen, so let's worry about that. And then lastly, I think AI is a fantastic productivity tool. And so there's some arguments that if someone wants to do something malicious, that a productivity tool could help them. But I feel like we're still falling short in terms of quantifying what really are the realistic risks. And just because a productivity tool may help someone do something bad, you know, how should we think about regulating productivity tools?
So you're almost trying to take out, draw out, rationalize some of so-called hype around the doom of AI. But at the same time, how do you practically think the US, and indeed as we wait for the EU potentially to have some sort of initial deal on the EU AI Act, how will regulation take form? Do they have to regulate the foundational models, or should they only regulate the application of AI?
I think that was a great insight. One thing that's important to know about AI is it's a general purpose technology, meaning it's useful for so many different things, from copy editing to chatting with people, to answering questions, to customer support. And so regulating the core technology is very difficult. To me, regulating the core technology makes as much sense as regulating high-powered electric motors, which could be used for all sorts of things. But once you take that electric motor and turn it into a electric vehicle or a blender, we can think about what are the risks of the applications, the car or the blender. When you take this AI technology and you build it into a medical device, let's make sure the medical device is safe. You take AI and put it in a self-driving car, let's make sure the self-driving car is safe. But I worry that if we put onerous regulation on the technology rather than the regulation, then we're slowing down the hundreds of thousands, maybe even more, beneficial applications that we could and should be using AI for.
I mean, we turn to you because of the expertise that you not only have at Stanford University as an academic, but also as an innovator in and of yourself and funding innovations with Landing AI, for example. I'm interested in whether you think innovation thus far is being stifled by preempting regulation that isn't actually there, because companies are having to get on advice. They are turning to consultants. They are trying to sort of ensure that they're building in the right way ahead of any real rules coming into place.
Yeah, the AI regulation space has been remarkable, with a lot of fears about long-term harms, even extinction risks. And today, one of the things that was discussed was to ask not what do you think are the risks of something leading to doom, but what are your hopes for AI? What do you think are the odds that AI will lead to a much better future for everyone? And a lot of us, including me, gave high estimates. I think AI has, I don't know, a 70% chance of letting us build a much better world. And then regulation to hold us back from that would be a problem. One of the things that was discussed a lot was the concern of regulatory capture. And I think there's actually one way to regulate, to avoid favoring big tech companies while stifling innovation from startups. And that is to take a tiered risk approach to AI, where we regulate the more risky things. Yeah. And I think that if you're a social media company with 100 million users, well, that has higher disinformation risk than a small message board with just 100 users. So let's regulate companies with a bigger reach more. That allows us to protect citizens while also avoiding regulatory capture.